Hello everyone. As you can tell from the strains of Cock of the North played on the mighty Wurlitzer organ there, it's time for this week's S.C.O.T. Soirée, which is with me, Michael Wooldridge. Before we get into the music, I would like to thank the whole team at the Scottish Cinema Organ Trust for actually having the vision to pop together this series of weekly programmes so that whilst we're all locked up indoors, we can still enjoy a dose of cinema organ, theatre organ music all together. All of the music we're going to hear this evening is taken from various private recordings of me playing Wurlitzer organs, most of which actually feature the wonderful Wurlitzer owned by the Scottish Cinema Organ Trust. I think it's no secret that it's one of my absolute favourite instruments in the UK, with that great big rich sound and that lovely acoustic that it has now at Pollokshaws, and indeed that it had previously at its home at Clydebank Town Hall. And that's where we're going for much of this evening's music, with extracts from a concert I played there on the 8th of June in 2003, which was recorded by one of the technical team, Frank Watson, who kindly sent me a copy of that concert. And in fact, it was hearing those recordings, the recordings we're going to hear tonight, that inspired me to return to make my Showtime Spectacular CD on the Wurlitzer. Such a lovely sound. We're going to kick off in big band style, and one of the greatest band leaders, I think, of all time, everyone would agree, is this one. Here come three tunes that were made famous by the Glenn Miller Orchestra.
Thank you.
Big Band Sounds At Last, Little Brown Jug and Moonlight Serenade, all played on the Clydebank Wurlitzer organ. Aside of travelling around playing concerts, I spent a day or two each week teaching children to play the organ in two schools in East Sussex. There's the Robertsbridge Community College, where I teach on behalf of the Theatre Pipe Organ Preservation Society. But the whole thing was kicked off down at Rye, where I've been teaching now for 10 years for the Rye Wurlitzer Academy, which has had remarkable results, really, with many of our students now actually playing concerts around and about, which is a joy. It's been a real pleasure to be involved with the project. We've taken a little step back in time now, just to give you a very tiny extract from a concert I played on the Rye Wurlitzer back in 1986. And what was special about the concert, which I think was promoted by the Theatre Organ Club, is that it featured not just me on the Wurlitzer, but also my teacher, Bobby Pagan, and a drummer by the name of Frank Stewart, who had enjoyed great success here before moving over to Australia, where he had his own big band and his own television show, but then in later years coming back home to England and working a lot both with Bobby and myself, playing for dances and functions and that sort of thing. So here's just a tiny bit from that concert, a medley from My Fair Lady, that great show. Here's just the tail end bit, I'm Getting Married in the Morning, and a little bit of I Could Have Danced All Night as the finale, featuring me on the Rye Wurlitzer, Bobby on piano and Frank on the drums. Sound of the Rye Wurlitzer many years ago. Since then, it's undergone extensive refurbishment and restoration, funded with various fundraising projects arranged by Richard Moore, and with the work carried out under the supervision of technical supremo David Wattenbach, and it has come on in leaps and bounds. The organ is a joy, and I thought it'd be nice to play you something more recent from Rye. So here's a recording just a couple of years ago of me playing that lovely classic jazz song, Body and Soul. Thank you. the lovely sounds of Body and Soul on the Rye Wurlitzer. Actually, the instrument is quite a small one. It's just under half the size of the Pollokshaw's Wurlitzer, but I'm sure you'll agree it is nonetheless a lovely sound. The previous track at Rye featured my teacher, Bobby Pagan, of course, a very proud Scotsman. He was born in Cooper, Fife, in April 1905 and went on to have a fabulous career in music. And this next little medley is in tribute to Bobby. The first one is his signature tune, the Pagan Love Song. And then just before the war in 1938, he was lent to the Palladium Cinema in Copenhagen to play Denmark's first Wurlitzer organ. And in fact, he ended up staying there longer than originally planned. It was going to be 3 months, but he ended up stopping right into July 1939. And whilst he was there, he composed a new signature tune for himself, taking the chimes that he heard from Copenhagen's City Hall and building a lovely tune based upon that called Copenhagen, You've Taken My Heart. So we hear the chimes featured very heavily in that piece. And then last but not least from Bobby is his arrangement of a novelty song, which really all the theatre organists, I think, used to play in one way or another. But this is Bobby's arrangement of The Whistler and His Dog. So I hope you enjoy these three tunes, remembering Bobby Pagan. Thank you. A nice fun ending there to Bobby Pagan's arrangement of The Whistler and His Dog, played by yours truly at the Clydebank Wurlitzer, along with two other memories of Bobby there. During the current pandemic, there have been many tributes paid to the sterling work being done by workers in our National Health Service and various care workers, looking after everybody and keeping them as safe as possible. And there was a lovely tribute paid on the internet by various of my colleagues, playing that great song, You'll Never Walk Alone, and all edited together by Andrew Nix, to have various people from around the country all playing together, but obviously in their own little parts and things, as a tribute to the National Health Service. And I thought we'd use that to finish off this evening's S.C.O.T. Soirée, You'll Never Walk Alone. But here it is as the grand finale to a whole medley of music from that wonderful Rodgers and Hammerstein musical, Carousel.
Thank you.
That's it from me this time, with special thanks to Frank Watson and Martin Simpson for their help with the various recordings, and also to Aaron Hawthorne and the Scott team for putting these programmes together. This is Michael Wooldridge saying thank you for listening, and I'll see you in a few weeks' time. Bye for now.